Welcome back to part 9, I think we're on. A riveting part 8. Marcus, from the muddy grounds of a junkyard, pulling his legs and his eyes and his heart and his ear from different random people's bodies, and even tearing the heart out of a non-lifeless body. Just killing it. I don't know what that text means. Killing it. Brought himself back to life, tore the chip out of his head, and then badass walked and pulled a trench coat off of a shovel. I mean, you can't get much more awesome than part 8 so far in the series. Marcus is a huge savage badass, and I'm loving him so far. Let's get into part 9. Connor, number 6. In the morning. So these are gonna intertwine in some way. Amanda, who is that and where are we? We are in some kind of awesome looking garden. I have to follow the path, so that's what we're gonna do. I immediately tried to walk off the path, but we had to follow it. I'm gonna take this weird little side path here. Maybe Amanda's over here. Y'all don't know. It's like weirdly, I don't know, this is an interesting little garden here. That tree's kind of cool. This whole thing's cool, honestly. Oh, I can just walk anywhere. I mean, I haven't seen Amanda. That looks like Amanda. That looks like her up on there. Or at least there's something yellow up there. Amanda or not, it's something. Excuse me, doves, pigeons, or whatever you are. Pigeons, probably. Are you Amanda? That does not look like an Amanda. Oh, maybe. Yeah, it does.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you.
She looks fierce. The hair, oof.
Congratulations, Connor. Finding that deviant was far from easy. And the way you interrogated it was very clever. You've been remarkably efficient, Connor.
Thank you, Amanda.
I got my doubts, Connor.
We've asked the DPD to transfer it to us for further study. It may teach us something about what happened. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
Traumatized.
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
Intriguing.
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Very much so.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous.
For you?
You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
I don't like Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
There's gonna be some decisions late in this game. I can already tell. Ooh, nice shoes.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
You snooping or no? Could I ask the question? Do we snoop or do we not snoop?
We really need the forensics.
Alright, I'll chase it up.
Read. It's obvious none of these people. Whoa, that looked like Todd. I can't guarantee it was Todd, but it looked like him. Collins, come on.
You and you come with
me. There we are.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Wow. Someone doesn't like Anderson. Let's do it. I've been itching. We're not sitters, Connor and me. We're explorers. Oops. Is that Zoom? Knights of the Black Death. Oh, that's so Anderson.
Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever. Beep.
Nah, not feeling it. He doesn't seem to be a message leaver. Canine hair, the Saint Bernard. Must have a dog. Jimmy's Bar, yeah. Anti-Android slogans. Okay. Not Pistons hat. Red Ice Dealers. Something over here. Red Ice Task Force. I bet you there was a different name on there that I didn't see. Donuts. Stereotypical. 452 calories. A lot of fat. A lot of carbs. Come on, man. A dead plant. Yeah, at least it looks dead. And a fresh cup of coffee. Seems strange that he would...
It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus.
Hank! In my office.
Let's explore the police station, people. Is that Carl? Oh, not Carl. President Warren's at 33% approval. Come on, Liz. Pull through. 10 new cases involving know what, let me explore, like, this way? Can I just walk around? Okay. Hello. It's fishy. Yeah, it's a debriefing. Oh, here we go.
Fuck, look at that. Our friend, the plastic detective, is back in town. Congratulations on last night. Very impressive.
Hello. My name is Connor.
That seemed a little dweeby.
Never seen an android like you before. Model, are you?
RK-800. I'm a prototype.
A prototype? Android detective. So a machine's gonna replace us all. Is that it? Hey.
You bet, asshole.
Bring me a coffee, dipshit. Get a move on! I gave you an order.
I'm sorry, but I only take orders from Lieutenant Anderson.
Oh.
This guy.
If Hank hadn't gotten in the way yesterday, I would have fucked you up for disobeying a human. Stay out of my way, because next time, you won't get off so easy.
Me and Chris.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police.
Chris is just me.
Although police assistant androids have existed.
Public opinion down. Why?
Would be the first case of an android being authorized.
Public opinion of themselves should be down. Is this where Hank went? Wants to do. Where's Hank? He's at his office. Wasn't he supposed to go in there? Pragmatic?
I know you don't like me, but we're going to have to work together. We'll both have to make an effort. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Where's the deviant at? I keep saying go see the deviant, but I don't... Must be down here, right? Is that what that thing said? There was a little red line that said go see the deviant or something like that. Oh, I had to analyze his files first. Are his files on my desk or am I just gonna be analyzing some random stuff here? Come on. God.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
This is so awkward.
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right?
Oh, Detroit Gears, okay.
Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh.
Oh, come on!
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, it's full of I don't really energy. Listen to music as such, but I'd like to.
I think I'm just going
to
start
If you have any
working.
Files on Deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Take a look at these samples yet?
I'm not gonna probe the anti. It just doesn't seem like that good of an idea. What am I looking for here? Whoa.
243 files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night.
Ooh!
That could be a good starting point for our investigation.
That's Kara. And that was Todd. Had to be.
I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. You need to move past them, and...
Hey, don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
We're plummeting with Hank.
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Ooh!
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
This is, tense coexistence here. I don't know. Hank just seems like everyone just hates these. They hate him. These androids. I mean, I guess I understand it. You know? I'm sure people that are losing their jobs, I guess if you lost your job to an android, I mean, I'd probably feel the same way, but at the same point, it's going to progress, the world is, and it's going to get more technologically advanced, and you just have to change with the times. You know, if a machine can build a car 20 times faster than a bunch of humans can, and save money, why would the higher-ups choose to keep you just so you can have a job? Like, at a certain point, you need to, you know, have a bottom line. And that's saving money and producing cars faster, which ends up making you more money. It just doesn't make any sense. You know, why would you have Hank, who is an old washed up sack of crap, when you can have Connor? You know? I could have solved this case already if it wasn't for Hank. Jesus, Christmas. I didn't do a lot of stuff, a lot of wandering while I was waiting for Hank. Where's the stuff about me getting a fight with? No, it's not even in there. Oh, it's talk with Gavin? Who's Gavin? Is Gavin the guy? I thought his name was Chris. I don't know, but we're about to collide with Kara. I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to take Kara's side or not. Probably. Kinda just kind of a stone-cold killer. Whatever. Thanks for watching part 9. We'll see you in part 10. Maybe we'll collide some worlds here.